In today's video, we're going to be talking about the Elements and Shadow Season 2, Episode 5. At the moment of recording this video, I can't seem to find the episode name because it's not on the thing I'm watching my anime on. But rest assured, I will be talking about that anime. Also, if you guys haven't seen the episode, there are spoilers, of course, obviously. Anyway, let's get into the review of the episode. Now, I want to say good stuff that I actually like about Season 2, first of all. I like how they're focusing more on, like, I forgot her name, but, like, Sid's sister. Yeah, I do like how they're focusing more on Sid's sister. I think last season we didn't really see her too much. We saw their relationship, but that's really all. And, yeah, okay, I do like how we also get more see more of Gamma, and how she's not really good at combat, but she's decent at everything else, like, brains. She's the brains, she's not really the fine type. We get to see more of her steps. We get to see her in this episode and her fighting, which she is really fast, so if she gets practice, she'll probably be decent at fighting, I think. Other than that, that's really stuff I do like, seeing more character development for characters. We also see Shadow Garden fight that master, that like Lord or whatever. Shadow, but of course his third identity, John Smith. They obviously don't know it. How it is, they don't like know who it is, but John Smith uses some wires to trap them, throws them up the thing. We also see more Rose, she's in that group, it's like that small kind of group. I think I forgot what number she's called, but they call her a number instead of her actual name. And a bunch of other stuff. I'm trying to think off the top of my tongue what I like. We see more of like the main person behind this arc, that guy, I think he's like blind or whatever. The guy who's like, I honestly don't remember his name because he's probably going to be gone in like 2 episodes time, considering how the Elements of Shadow normally work. Of course, that all leads back to the occult and all that kind of stuff. Even if Sid did end up making it up, it was an actual thing. So the occult still is something the Shadow Garden hold deeply. And I have read the manga, so I kind of do know what's going to happen. But for the episode, I think it's really good. Personally, I do give it a, I do like all the contract, 8 out of 10. I'll give it 8 out of 10. But what I do like the most, like I said, I do like how Shadow's acting his own intention, John Smith, creating that personality for himself. I think it really brings more development to Shadow and Sid. Even if he is our favourite background character, he is, without a doubt, he is the main character, so that makes sense. Also, I don't know if it's just me, but in the episode, it repeated the same thing twice, like two scenes that the same thing repeated. The same episode, like, two scenes repeated constantly. At first, I was like, is that some like time power being used here or something? I don't actually know, unless it's just like the thing I'm using, it like repeated it. That's the only thing I can tell from it, but other than that, I have no idea what happened. So if that's actually a thing, please let me know, because I don't know if it's the app I use just like repeat the same thing twice. But yeah, anyway, I'll see you next video. Like I said, it's 8 out of 10 for me, and yeah, bye.